for the first time in human history, we have the tools to figure out whether we're alone in the universe. Around every second star, there's at least one planet. And around every fifth, there's a planet that's small enough to be a rock and at the right distance where it's not too hot, not too cold, for it to maybe be a second Earth. And we have 200 billion stars in our galaxy, the Milky Way alone. Maybe there's no life out there. Maybe it's everywhere. I have no answer to that yet. But with the next telescopes, and that's just a couple of years in the waiting now, we'll be able to tell. The James Webb Space Telescope that's going to go up into space in 2018, 6.5 meter in diameter, an even bigger one we're building on the ground. That's going to be 40 meters and it's called the European Extremely Large Telescope. So that we can collect enough light of these other worlds, these planets orbiting other stars, that we can analyze it. So when we look at these planets, how do we actually tell that there's life? Light is really energy, but that energy can hit the molecules in the atmosphere of a planet, like oxygen, water, or methane. Once the light made it filter through the air of this other world to us, it's like a passport in a way, stamped by whichever molecule it crossed, because that's the light that didn't make it to us. That tells you uniquely what molecules are in the air of this other world. And I try to take all of this together and say, if there's life, this is what we would see. If there's not life, this is what we would see. And actually envisioning how different planets could be like, it's gonna change our worldview to know that we are not alone, and to maybe, when you sit under the stars, be able to point up there and say, there's a planet where maybe somebody right now is asking whether they are alone in the universe too.